Hi, Candace. Thanks for sitting down with me today to talk a little bit about pencil power.
Thank you so much for talking with me, Amanda. It's exciting to do this.
Yeah. So I have a few questions for you.
Okay.
The first one is, what is pencil power?
Pencil power is an awesome program that is a six-week handwriting club, or a program you could call it, that is designed to be a part of a school district's or a school building's multi-tiered systems of support. So this is a tier two intervention that allows students to be eligible to come to a small group. And it's a six-week group. And the students come to this group for 30 minutes once a week, just like they would a therapy session, and they practice warm-ups for handwriting. They've actually practiced some of the foundations of handwriting, and they learn a lot of tips and strategies that they would learn in a handwriting session with an OT, but it doesn't have to be run by an OT.
Okay, great. So who benefits from pencil power?
So I would say the sweet spot would be first graders. First graders seem to be at the place where they've learned the foundations of handwriting in kindergarten, and they're practicing these skills. So students who are struggling and who might need a boost, who are in the regular education program, they would be the ones that would benefit the most from pencil power.
Okay. So is pencil power a handwriting curriculum?
No, it's not a curriculum. This is an RTII or multi-tier systems of support program. So this is designed as a classroom boost for students who are struggling in the regular education program.
Okay. And how easy is it to implement?
It's really easy. We have a screener that sometimes will be handed out to all first grade classrooms, and the teacher implements the screener with the students, and then sometimes the occupational therapist will score them. Or teachers can sometimes identify students that they feel like are struggling with handwriting, and then those students are screened and scored by the OT. And students, we made a threshold of 75%. So if a student is below that, they would be eligible for the group. And that's kind of how we start going with it.
Okay. I know that you mentioned previously the group leader does not need to be an OT.
It doesn't. That's the beauty of pencil power. It can be an occupational therapist, but it can also be a paraprofessional, a reading specialist aide, parent volunteers. There's a lot of opportunities for the group leader to not be an OT, which makes this so great as an RTII or MTSS approach.
Okay, so what prompted the creation of pencil power?
Many, many, many moons ago, when I was an occupational therapist in a school, I really felt like my skills as an OT, not that they were being wasted on handwriting instruction, not by any means, but I felt like that wasn't my passion in OT, and I felt like there should be other ways for students to be able to get a boost and to get handwriting practice and to get handwriting instruction and supplemental instruction, and really the foundations of that. Felt like there should be other ways before it comes to OT, because really we're looking at the fine motor component, the visual motor component, visual perceptual skills, postural control, all of these underlying foundations for handwriting, not necessarily the actual handwriting instruction. So I really wanted a way to be able to allow students to get support and to get help, but not necessarily need it to be from an OT. And then if they do need more after going through the program, then I felt like it would be appropriate for OT to get involved. What else is going on with the student that's making handwriting so hard if it's not supplemental instruction through an RTII approach or an MTSS approach?
Okay. So do you need to collect data with this program?
Yes. Data collection is key. So we have a pre-screener, and we have a screener, and we have a post-test. So at the end of the six-week program, students take the same screener and we compare the scores. So, and students who did not make progress are eligible to go on and go another 6 weeks in the program. Students who passed the screener or made improvements then return back to the classroom using all of their strategies and things that they learned in pencil power.
Okay. So what has the feedback been with pencil power?
We've gotten great feedback, and that's kind of how we've discovered that first grade was a sweet spot for this, and maybe the beginning of second grade. We've found that this has been a great program to be used as a bigger part of a child study team or a core team that's looking for data and collecting data on students who are struggling academically. What we've found is that a third of students go through the first 6 weeks and then they do not need any more supports. And then the last two-thirds of that group will go through the second 6 weeks, and two-thirds, like another third of those students move through and don't need any further supports. And then we're left with this last third of students. And those are the kids that are really struggling with school. So those are the students that are typically going through a multidisciplinary evaluation to see if there are any other academic or learning needs going on. And OT then becomes a part of that bigger evaluation that's done, and we kind of figure out what's really going on with the student. So it's been a great way to offer a screening tool and supports to students who are struggling, and to really identify who needs help with those underlying skills.
Okay. So where can someone find Pencil Power or learn more information?
Yeah, that's a great question. So for those of you working with PTS already, please contact your clinical director. They have lots of information on it. If you are not currently a PTS client or school district that we work with, please check out our website, www.capableclassroom.com. And that has pictures of the program, and it also has pricing and more information.
Great. Well, thank you so much for sitting down with me, giving us more information about Pencil Power.
Thanks so much for having me.